place, of course, the musical. Urinetown, the place is, well, you'll hear people referring to it a lot throughout the show.
You hear the news? They carted old so-and-so off to Urinetown the other day.
Is that so? What'd he do?
Oh, such and such I hear.
Well, what do you know? Old so-and-so.
It's kind of a mythical place, you understand? A bad place. A place you won't see until Act Two, and then, well, let's just say it's filled with symbolism, things like that. But Urinetown, the musical, well, here we are, welcome. It takes place in a town like any town that you might find in a musical. This here's the first setting for the show. As the sign says, it's a public amenity, meaning public toilet. These people have been waiting in line for hours just to get in. It's the only amenity they can afford to get into.
Is this the part where you tell the audience about the water shortage?
What's that, little Sally?
You know, the water shortage, the hard time, the drought, a shortage so awful the private toilets eventually became unthinkable. A promise so absurd!
Whoa there, little Sally. Not all at once. They'll learn more about the water shortage in the next scene.
Oh, I guess you don't want to overload them with too much exposition, huh?
You're right, little Sally. Nothing can kill a show like too much exposition.
How about bad subject matter?
Well...
Or bad title even. That could kill a show pretty good.
Well, little Sally, suffice it to say, then Urinetown, the musical, everyone has to use public bathrooms in order to take care of their private business. That's the central conceit of the show. Better hope your penny to the fee, we can't have you peeing for free. If you do, we'll catch you. We never fail, and we never bother with jail.
You'll get Urinetown. Up you'll go to Urinetown. Away with you to Urinetown.
You won't need bail. Later on, you'll learn that these bathrooms are controlled by a private company. They keep admission high, generally. So if you're down on your luck, you have to come to a place like this. One of the poorest, filthiest urinals in town.
And you can't school in the bushes either. There's laws against it.
That's right, little Sally. Harsh laws, too. That's why little Sally here is counting her pennies. Isn't that right, little Sally?
I'm very close, officer. Only a few pennies away.
Aren't we all, little Sally? Aren't we all?
Excuse me, sir, but can you show me the way to the private company that owns these public bathrooms?
You mean you're in good company?
That's the one.
You'll meet the man who runs You're in Good Company later. That there's his daughter.
It's quite a ways from here, miss. This here's the bad part of town.
So it is.
But if you squint, you can just make out their headquarters rising above the skyline.
The gleaming tower on the hill?
That's the one.
Gosh, it's beautiful.
You most certainly are.
Pardon?
It most certainly is.
Oh dear, I'm late already. Thanks ever so much for the directions and such. Goodbye.
Anytime.
Well, we've talked on for long enough, I imagine. Enjoy the show, and welcome to Urinetown, the musical.
You are humble audience.
yesterday's fiasco, and that means you've been strong.
443, 444, 445. Just a few more. 7. Penny for a piece, sir? Please, sir. Spare a penny for a morning piece, sir?
Oh, what's that?
Or a nickel or a dime.
Out of my way, child. I got king of my own attend to.
Got it.
Then go get it.
Come on, Penny. I'm good for it.
That's what you said last week, and I still haven't seen Penny one. And it's Ms. Pennywise to you.
Bobby reason with the woman. I'm a little short this morning.
No shorter than yesterday. Unless I've grown.
He's my pa, Ms. Pennywise. Can't he come in for free? Just this once?
Get your head out of the clouds, Bobby Strong. No one gets in for free.
Now, Ms. Pennywise, we've all had to make special arrangements with people in high places over the years. Why not let this one be ours?
If old man Strong gets in for free, then so do I.
And I!
And I! Quiet back there! No one's getting anywhere for free! Don't you think I have bills of my own to pay? Don't you think I have taxes and tariffs and payoffs to meet too? Well, I do. And I don't pay them with promises, see? I pay them with cash. Cold, hard cash. Every morning you all come here, and every morning some of you got reasons why you ain't gonna pay. But I'm here to tell you, you is gonna pay.
But Miss Pennywise.
No buts, Bobby.
In the name of God, Penny, what difference could it make?
What difference? Times are hard, our cash is tight, you've got no right, I've heard it all before. Just this once is once too much, cause once they once, they'll wanna once more. I run the only toilet in this part of town, you see. So if you gotta go, you've got to go through me. It's a privilege to pee. Water's worth its weight in gold these days. No more bathrooms like in olden days. You come here and pay a fee for the privilege to pee. 20 years we've had the drought, and our reservoirs have all dried up. I take my baths now in a coffee cup. I boil what's left of it for tea. And it's a privilege to pee. The politicians in their wisdom saw that there should be a law. The politicians taxed the toilets and made illegal public urination and defecation. So come and give your coins to me. Write your name here in the record book. The authorities will want to look if you've been regular with me. If you paid the proper fee for the privilege to pee.
Bobby, said
no buts, Bobby. You're a sweet looking boy, and I'd like to take you around. This man ain't coming in without paying. Not this time.
I can't wait much longer, Bobby. Just don't tell me what I'm going to do.
You think you got some kind of right?
Kind of right, kind of right.
You think you'll come in here and go for free?
Saga free.
The only thing you'll get is no for free.
Negatory.
I'm a business gal.
Business gal, you see.
I sell
the privilege to be.
Jeopardize your position.
Or better yet, have you arrested?
I'm through with all this, you'll see.
Since you prefer the law gets tested.
Drinking cash 3 times a day.
And in Urinetown, you'll see.
Crazy with the nitrates half the time.
Why, it's dumb to fight with me.
There's nowhere to live, I tell you. Nowhere to live.
For the
lost your mind?
More than that, boy. A whole lot more than that.
Looky there.
That's old man Strong. He ain't waiting.
He's peeing right there in the pavement. He is.
He's going and I'm going.
Oh, no, you're not.
All right, then make way.
Make way, damn you. Make way.
Ah, that's better.
So, it ain't old man Strong.
The same.
Is this your doing Strong?
It is.
Seize him. You've done a terrible thing here today, Strong.
I did what I thought was necessary.
Grab him off, Bobby. Never thought I'd live to see the day.
Breaking the Public Health Act is an exiling offense, Strong.
Quite exiling.
So what it is. I feel better now, and that's all I cares about.
Oh, Pa.
Always knew we'd get you in the end, Joseph Strong. Take him away.
Bobby!
Pa!
Don't forget me, Bobby!
I won't, Pa!
Tell your mother! Tell your mother that I love her!
I will, Pa! I will!
Remember me, boys! Oh, God, what have I done? Remember me!
Remember Bobby, what came of him.
Remember
how he indulged the whim.
Remember.
Remember how he made the mockery. He shunned the crockery. Don't be like him.
Don't be
what
like
became of him.
Him.
What do you mean by that?
Like just keep him. Your head out of the clouds, Bobby like Strong. That's all I'm saying. Like good day.
Like all right, who's ready to pay?
It's my last few dollars, but I'll pay. Me too.
Me too.
We'll all pay Bobby Strong, always and forever. Just so long as you keep letting us pay.
Oh, Pa, what's to become of you?
Back to work then, Bobby. The morning rushes on.
Where's my dough?
Isn't that what we're all asking ourselves, Senator?
Where's my dough?
From the cop walking his beat to the little baby asleep in his mother's arms, we're all asking the same question.
Where's my dough? And by dough, of course, I mean money.
I made my speech. Where's my dough?
Don't you worry, Senator. There'll be plenty of dough for everyone once those new fee hikes breeze through the legislature.
Was hoping to wait for the vote during my latest fact-finding mission to Rio. Wouldn't want to be around when those new fee hikes breeze through.
You think I'm going too far this time, don't you?
It's a powder keg out there, Cladwell, and this time it's gonna blow.
Daddy?
What? Hope, darling. I thought you'd never get here.
Sorry I'm late, Daddy. I came just as soon as my exams were finished.
How's everything, dear?
Fine, Daddy, just fine. It feels great to be done with school, finally.
See there, Miss McQueen? Beautiful, big-hearted, and now with the head filled with the best stuff money can buy.
Well, sir, if the stuff in her head is nearly as big as the stuff in her heart, I'm sure she'll be running this company in no time.
That'll be all, Miss McQueen?
Yes. Of course.
Well, I'll be. Hope, Clavel, and all grown up, too.
Hello, Senator.
Come to join your father's little operation.
Oh, it's just a fax copy position, of course. First day.
Fax copy girl, huh? You know, your father mentioned he'd be bringing on a new fax copy girl. Neglected, however, to mention how beautiful she'd be. You'd be. You are so beautiful. You know, ever since you was a little girl, I always thought
that's
this.
That's enough.
Of course.
Well, we won't keep you, Senator. It's a big day. I'm sure you'll have your hands on the floor of the legislature, what with the fee hike vote and all.
Oh, there'll be full, Gladwell. And by this time tomorrow, I fully expect them to be full of cash.
Oh, they'll be full of cash, Senator. We'll all be full of cash, provided the vote comes through.
That vote will come through, Gladwell. As soon as you come through with that cash.
No worries there, Senator. Once the vote comes through, there'll be nothing else to come through but the cash.
And no need to worry about that vote because...
I think we understand each other.
Yeah, well, goodbye.
Let's meet the staff. Staff!
Hey,
is my daughter, and our newest fax copy girl,
Hope Gladwell.
Hope Gladwell, the good people of You're in Good Company, or UGC, as known for short.
Hello, everybody!
Hello, Hope!
Say a few words, Hope Garling.
Well, it's a great company, and I hope to help you make it even greater.
Well, that's absolutely right, Hope. You're absolutely right. For you see, ladies and gentlemen, 20 years ago, we came to the people of this community with a simple proposition. Look the other way, while we run this company the way we see fit, and we'll keep the pee off the street and the water on the ground. Hope here has come to join our little operation to help us keep that promise. So promise me, you'll treat her like the Gladwell she is. For one day, she may be standing in the shoes you see me wearing today. The shoes I wore when I made that promise those many years ago. I saw gray skies foreboding and cold. I saw gray skies and made them rain gold. Now those skies aren't so bleak to behold. They're still gray, but they pay for your salaries tenfold. I took this town that formerly stank. I took this town and made it smell swank. I made flushing mean flush at the bank. I'm the man with the plan, and so who should you thank?
Who?
Mr. Gladwell.
Oh, me?
We're so thankful for the faithful of Joe. You're a Tory adore, and this cash that you wore, could we hope for much more? We really doubt it.
You may be right there.
Mr. Gladwell, you've got riches, which is just what we need. We say hell to you, the Duke of the Duckets.
I can bring in bucks by the buckets.
You're the master, you're making money.
Faster still, the bee's making honey.
You're Mr. Gladwell.
Gosh, I never realized large monopolizing corporations could be such a force for good in the world.
Few do.
All those coins that we take from the throng end up here where those coins all belong. Lots of coins make our company strong.
Charging fees as we please is our right, it's not wrong.
We're not greedy, as some make us seem. We need coins for our big research team. What it shows, no one knows. But hey, still we can dream of.
Dad!
It's your
Gladwell. That's my dad!
Finding answers.
Da-da-da-da-daddy!
Curing answers of doubt.
That's my dad!
Your ambitions are high.
Making me blush now.
Mr. Gladwell, you're so godly, godly, perfect and bright.
You are continental yet unpretentious,
fancy free and so conscientious,
wise but trendy, tough as a mountain,
goodness grows from you like a fountain.
Nonsense. Did I send you to the most expensive university in the world to teach you how to feel conflicted or to learn how to manipulate great masses of people?
To learn how to manipulate great masses of people, Daddy.
Which is exactly what we'll do. Now get faxing.
And copying.
And welcome home.
Well, hello there, little Sally. Awfully late for a little girl to be out and about, especially on a night like tonight.
Oh, just trying to scrape together a few coins before the late night rush is all. Got one to spare?
Sure, little Sally. I'm in a good enough mood.
Gee, thanks. Say, Officer Lockstock, I was thinking, we don't spend too much time on hydraulics, do we?
Hydraulics, little Sally?
You know, hydraulics. Hydration, irrigation, or just plain old laundry. Seems to me with the talk about the water shortage and the drought and whatnot, we might spend some time on those things too, you know. After all, a dry spell would affect hydraulics.
Well, I'm sure it would, little Sally, but how should I put this? Sometimes, in a musical, it's easier to focus on one big thing rather than a bunch of little things. The audience tends to be happier that way, and it's easier to write.
One big thing, huh?
That's right, little Sally.
Oh. Then why not hydraulics?
Now run along, little Sally. Wouldn't want you to miss last call. Miss Pennywise won't keep the gate open forever, you know.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for the coin. Bye.
What a night.
Everything cleaned up all right, Mr. Barrow?
Sure, same as always. Did you hear him scream, though, Officer Lockstock?
Old man Strong?
All the way down to Urinetown.
Oh, yes, I heard him. But they all seem to scream me in now, don't they? As their journey down the exile comes to a close, and the spires of Urinetown peak above the horizon? Oh yes, Mr. Barrow, they do scream. They most certainly do.
I suppose I thought he might be different, somehow.
Different?
Old man Strong. Well, he seemed a bit tougher than the rest. Thought he might, I don't know, surprise us somehow.
If there's one thing that I've learned in my many years of enforcing the laws of the city, it's that the journey down to Urinetown offers no surprises. Not even for the toughest amongst us. On that journey down to Urinetown, expect only the expected. Well, it's a hard, cold tumble of a journey, worthy of a gurney, a bumble down. A slapped face smacked with a mace, stirring to the bases or stumbled down. It's a path that leads you only one place, horrible to retrace, a crumbled down. A hard, cold tumble of a tourney, jumble of a journey to Urinetown.
Julie Cassidy went to a field behind a tree, saw there was no one who could see
her pee
but me.
And Jacob rose in blue, thought he was safe up in his room, didn't know the jars he kept up there. I'll get a trip to your entomb.
Well, there are those who think our method vicious,
overly malicious,
a bunch of brutes, but it's we who gather for the people,
tavern to the steeple,
lawful fruits. Our task, bring a little order,
swindle out of order,
from what he loots, as the book says, certainly a season,
trample out of trees,
hop now boots.
Roger Roosevelt kept a cup below his belt, cup ran over when he knelt.
He smelt?
We dealt.
And Joseph, old man strong, held his pee for much too long, hoped his son would bail him out. His guess was good, but also wrong.
A jungle scooping out a bungle, nature's bowl, life of constant deprivation, certain aggravation took its toll. Soon learned power of the truncheon, organized a function, came to pawn. So if peace is what you're after, Urinetown's the rafter to hang it on.
Down to the path that leaves you only one place, horrible to reach, there's a crumble.